Rhino, and he's reacting to a video about do trans teens all agree and all think the same thing. And Max thought about, because I just saw him answer a question, and I don't agree with him. His answer in the question is, that, should kids be able to medically transition? My answer is no, and it doesn't change, because, blockers, yeah, they're medicine, but they're not hormones, and they don't change your body. They just block your hormones, and they're completely irreversible, and they don't have any side effects or anything like testosterone, growing hair, deep voice, or estrogen. I don't know what that is. Makes me more moody. Because guys can't get periods. Cis guys can't get periods. And trans guys can't get periods. So I don't know what estrogen all those do. Maybe you get a little fat in your chest. But yeah. It just blocks the blockers. Yeah. But hormones, no. And obviously surgery, no. You had to be adult. Obviously, consenting and everything. You're obviously foreign at fault, and you know the risks, and you were evaluated by the professionals and everything. So, and if you regret it, and you're like, it was a horrible mistake, I regret it. To detransition now, I wasted all this time and energy, and no one should have supported me and all this. No, you are just adult, and just another mistake you made. Like, some people should transition, some people shouldn't. And if you did, and you had to reverse it and you had to detransition, then you made the wrong mistake. Like, it's not that big deal. Yeah, it's permanent or whatever if you got surgery. Performance is not permanent. And then you kind of can reverse it if you get a different type of surgery. You kind of can just reverse it with a different type of surgery. You just can't completely undo it. And it depends on all what you all got done for surgery. But yeah, for the most part, you can just be reversed. So it's not that big of a deal. And even then, it's just a mistake. And you're like, but it's permanent. Like tattoos. But now they can be lasered off, so I don't know. And like piercings. It's a permanent hole in your body. But then it can close up, you know? Obviously, not without scars and, like, side effects, but, you know. Permanent has changed. I don't know why or how. And I don't know any of the details about that. But, yeah. If it's permanent and you regret it, then it's just like getting a tattoo, changing hair dye, but usually that doesn't last as long as a tattoo and piercing. So tattoos and piercings. And abortion, getting an abortion, getting a hysterectomy, getting your uterus ripped out, all of that. It's just another regret you get. Plastic surgery, permanent. It's just another regret, just another mistake. Credit card debt. See? It's just another mistake. Something that can be permanent and can destroy and mess up your life. But it's just a mistake you have to learn from, and you just apparently have to go through. You don't want to, but you had to learn that it was a mistake. Because for some reason you weren't able to figure it out before. And we usually just learn from our mistakes, and we have to make mistakes to learn most of the time anyway. Okay, I forgot the question. But yeah, my answer is no. You gotta be an adult. And I had to be an adult. And, for when I was 17, no one gave me blockers, or Max just got Norethrone. She's like, oh, that's a blocker, because it's just birth control without estrogen. So it made me have less of a period. So that was just helpful. And then Max was just getting meds for depression and anxiety. So, you know. Yeah. So Max didn't have any tea. And then even before, when I wasn't able to get tea, then my mom stole my meds and flipped out. And also, I was forced to let her in a counseling session, and then she was calm, and then she flipped out afterwards, and then I never went to counseling again. So that was great. Thanks for that. And the counselor also made me cry, so I don't really blame her. And I'm kind of happy that we never saw the therapist again. But yeah, but we didn't see any therapist, and then she was trying to find the right therapist. She's like, they have to be Christian and all this crap. So I had to find my own therapist and everything, even though I couldn't drive. And yeah, that was great. So yeah, but no, she stole my medication, and now I have to go and pick up my meds, even though Max can't leave his bed half the time. But Max has to, because otherwise, if I let my mom pick it up like before, my meds will disappear. I'll just never get any meds. So, yeah, that's fun. So, Max has to go directly pick up meds, because to prevent that from happening again, and mom going and trying to be helpful and picking up my meds, you gotta block. You gotta put a block so only one person's allowed to pick it up, and that's you. And no one else can touch your meds. So it doesn't happen again. I had to explain this whole entire mess. The whole mess of my meds. I'm like, my mother took them, and I cannot get my meds. My mom, like, drained them, deleted them. I have no idea. So you need to give me more, and you can't use it as a refill, because I still need all those refills, and neither of us knew that you were giving meds to a crazy person who would not give me my meds. The delivery person failed, so you need to give me more meds. Later, she gave me my meds, but I couldn't take them, because I couldn't trust them, because I have no idea what she did to them. So that's great.